In this video, I'll walk you through the QuickGrid component, which is a Razor component designed for quickly and efficiently displaying data in a tabular format. In our QuickGrid setup, we'll display data, make the columns sortable, add custom columns, implement filter options, and ensure the grid displays data in pages based on the page size selected by the user. So, let's get started. To use QuickGrid in Blazor, we first need to install a library named microsoft.asp.netcore.components.quickgrid from NuGet packages. I've already created an entity class named User, which includes properties like first name, last name, email, username, password, and more. Also, in my database, you can see the table populated with some dummy data. We'll be placing the QuickGrid inside this User Grid Razor component, which already has some components for selecting page size and a button for adding a new user. Here, I'm fetching the users from the database while loading the page. You can download the entire source code of this project from our Patreon community. So, let's go ahead and place the QuickGrid here. We can assign the necessary classes for styling. For the items property, we'll provide the users list as queryable data. Additionally, we can assign the item key property as the unique ID, which allows the grid to preserve the association between row elements and data items based on their unique identifiers. Now, inside the QuickGrid, we can define the property columns that we want to display. The title attribute sets the header text for each column, while the property attribute defines the value to be displayed in that column's cells. Let me go ahead and create property columns for all the required properties. For specific properties like datetime, decimal, or integer, we can also define the appropriate formatting. Once we run the application, you'll see all the data displayed in the grid, and the datetime property will be shown in the format we specified. Now, let's see how we can make the columns sortable. It's simple. We just need to set the sortable property of a property column to true. Let me go ahead and make all columns sortable except for the email column. As you can see, we can now click the column header and sort the data in ascending or descending order. However, the email column isn't sortable since we haven't assigned the sortable property. We also have the option to set a column to be sorted by default. I'm assigning the initial sort direction property to descending. When the page loads, you'll notice that the column is already sorted in descending order. Now, let's try adding a new user, which will save the latest date time. As you can see, the newly added user appears at the top of the list because the grid is sorted by the latest date time. After the page loads, we can still change the sort order by clicking the column header just like before. Next, let's see how we can include custom columns in the QuickGrid. For that, we'll use the template column. Here, I'm adding options to edit and delete users. When the edit option is clicked, I'll invoke the onEdit event callback, which I've already created. I need to pass the user object as a parameter, and for that, we can use the context object, which represents the user item of the particular row. If you're new to Blazor and want to dive deeper, check out our Blazor tutorial series. The playlist link is available in the video description. Similarly, we have a delete method set up. Let's call this method when clicking the delete option. Now, in the application, you can see an additional column with the edit and delete options. Let's go ahead and try editing a user. After making some small changes, I'll save, and as you can see, the user details have been successfully updated. Now, let's try deleting a user. As expected, the user has been removed from the list. Now, let's see how we can implement filter options in QuickGrid. QuickGrid allows us to define column options inside a property column. For this example, I'm adding a simple input field and a button inside the column options. Next, I'll create a string variable for the username filter. I'll also modify the loadData method. If the username filter is empty, we'll fetch all users. Otherwise, we'll filter the data by the username. Now, we can bind the username filter to the input field and the button will trigger the load data method. In the application, you can now see an icon on the left side of the column header, which displays the filter options when clicked. Let me try entering a value. As you can see, the data is now filtered based on the input. If we clear the filter, it reloads all the data. Now, let's see how we can implement pagination in QuickGrid. First, we need to create a pagination state object. I'll set the items per page value to 5. Next, we'll provide this pagination state object to the QuickGrid by assigning it to the pagination property. Now, let's place the paginator component. I'll add it here in the card footer, and we'll assign the same pagination state object to its state property. On the page, we already have a select component for changing the page size. When the page size is changed, we'll update the items per page property of the pagination state to the selected value. Now, in the application, you can see only 5 rows are displayed in the grid, and the paginator appears below. Let's try navigating to different pages. We can also change the page size using this select component. As you can see, 10 rows are now displayed, and now it's showing 25 rows. You can refer to the source code in our Patreon community to gain a deeper understanding of the implementation. Join our community to level up your skills and access exclusive benefits. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. See you all in the next video. Thank you.